Good morning, children. Are you ready for today's class? Okay. So let us continue with P.T. Usha, the Golden Girl, Segment 2. Segment 2 begins from academically till Usha's hometown. Okay. So today we are going to learn some new words. They are inseparable. Inseparable means something which cannot be separated. Meticulous. Meticulous means showing great attention to detail. Meticulous means showing great attention to detail. Very careful and precise is the other meaning. The next one is systematic. Systematic means methodological. Means a method is there and that method only is going to be followed. Serious. Earnest means serious. Vastness means to a great extent. Serenity means calmness. Serenity means calmness. Enhanced means to make greater or to make better. Dedicated means devoted to a task. Devoted to a task. Immense is large or great. Extremely large or great. Understood? This is a gold medal. This is a silver medal which is given to a second winner. That is, the runner-up is given a silver medal. This is a bronze medal which is given to a person who comes third in the sport. Usually medals are given for sports, not for games. Games means a group of people playing or a team which is playing. So shields or trophies will be given for a group. Whereas if a sport is played, that is an individual game or individual performance is seen, medals are given to them. Understood this? Now let us begin segment 2 reading of the lesson. So let's read the lesson. Academically, Usha was an extremely bright student. She was always among the top 3 in her class and was popular with her teachers. She passed her standard 7 exams with a first class grade. Just then, the government of Kerala announced a separate sports division for girls at Kannanore, a town with specialties for sports in addition to regular studies. So here we can see that she was a bright student. That means she was good at her studies. She was among the top 3. That means among 1, 2, 3 ranks, she was there and she was popular. Popular means very famous with her teachers. She passed her class 7 exams. In those days, they used to have board exam for class 7. So she passed her standard 7 exams with first class grade. That means it is A1. Okay, all the children who are getting A1, they get the first class. Just then the government, so after the results have been released, the government of Kerala, she was from Kerala, so the government has announced that there's a separate sports division. So in a place called Kannanore, it's a town, and here a place was given for the girls who were interested in sports as well as education. So this girl, P.T. Usha, Pilavalakandi Tekkaparambal Usha, joined in that school. So Usha joined the sports division at Kannanore to improve her sport talent. She was left in the safe hands of P.H. Paithal, the headmaster of the school. It was at Kannanore that another great master fired her imagination so much that together they achieved the impossible. His name was Madhavan Nambiar. So So here we can see that she has joined Cananor, where she was able to improve her talent in the sport, and she was, and now the headmaster is P.H. Paithal. What is P.T. Usha's father's name? Very good. It is also Paithal. You can see here Paithal. Second daughter of Paithal. So father's name is Paithal and the principal's name is also Paithal. And there is a PT sir in that school and his name is Madhavan. What is his name? Madhavan. And he was helping her to achieve her goals. Both of them together were able to achieve many medals. By 1977, Usha and Nambiar were inseparable. Nambiar had found the word he had been waiting for all his life, and Usha had found her guru. Nambiar would, from now on, care for her like a father. Usha's meticulous, systematic training began in earnest. Here you can see many words coming. Inseparable, we have already seen. What is the meaning of inseparable, children? They cannot be separated. So Usha and Nambiar, PT sir and Usha, they were inseparable. They were not able to be separated, unable to be separated. Nambiar had found the word he had been waiting for all his life. Now Nambiar was waiting for a child who was zealous about sports. And here he found a student who was very much hard working, and Usha also found a guru, a teacher who was able to help her and guide her in a proper way so that she could reach her imagination. Nambiar would from now on, so now Nambiar only is taking care of her like a father. He was very much keen about her. He was meticulous, means showing great attention to detail, very careful and precise. So Usha very carefully by Madhavan sir, and systematic training was given. Systematic means a proper method was there. Usually when you go for sports and games, what do? First you do your warm-ups. After the warm-ups are finished only, you go for the actual game or sport. So same way, there was a plan which is made by Madhavan sir, how many times warm-ups should be done, what are the exercises which come under warm-ups, and how to practice and all that. He has planned everything systematically and he began in earnest. Earnest means seriously. They were concentrating more on their sport. Now let us read the next one. Usha had a regular training run on the beach of Payoli. She preferred to be trained alone, for the vastness of the beach gave her a sense of freedom. She ran joyfully and freely, and she derived her strength from the serenity and peace of her beloved Kerala surroundings. Nambiar introduced his sand training in her program to enhance her performance in the athletics. Just after the 1982 New Delhi Asian Games, sand training had enhanced the performance of many great athletes, from Edwin Moses to top flight Indian athletes like Milkha Singh and Sriram Singh. So here we can see that Usha was being given a regular training on the beach. Beach means what, children? Where do you see a beach? Yes, beside the rivers, or you'll have the sand and there's a small area. There's an area to sit and enjoy. So near the beach, Payoli, she used to run in the beach of Payoli, and she preferred to be trained alone. She did not go for group runs. She just wanted to stay alone and be trained. Vastness means, we have learnt, very great extent or size. So the beach was really very big, and she enjoyed running, and she felt that she had the sense of freedom. She ran joyfully. She was happy to run, and freely she was running. And the calmness and the peace of Kerala surroundings made her run very fast. Then she was introduced to sand training. Can you walk fast in sand, children? No, it is difficult to walk fast. And can you imagine running in the sand? It is a difficult thing. So here the master, who is a Nambiar, started giving her training in the sand. He made her run in the sand, and which helped her to enhance, means to become better. She became better in her performance when she ran in the sun. And after the Asian Games, New Delhi Asian Games, she was able to improve her. Okay. Edwin Moses is an American athlete who is to run 400 meters hurdles. Hurdles means, do you know, children? Hurdles means in between they used to keep some bars or something will be there, and you need to jump over that and run. So Edwin Moses was a 400 meter hurdles athlete, American athlete. Then coming to Milkha Singh. Milkha Singh is an Indian track and field athlete. He is called as the Flying Singh. He broke many records. Then Sriram Singh is another Indian runner who ran for 800 meters. Who ran 800 meters? He is from Rajasthan. Milkha Singh is from Punjab. Edwin is from America. Milkha is from Punjab. Sriram is from Rajasthan. Let us continue reading. Usha's athletic achievements are well known to almost all Indians. Two silver medals in the 1982 New Delhi Asian Games, fourth place in the 400 meters at the 1984 Jakarta Asian Meet, and four golds and one silver at the 1986 Asian Games in Seoul. So here you can see so many medals are there in her. On her there are so many medals, and we can see that she got two silver medals. Already I have shown you what are silver, gold and bronze medals. So two silver medals she has achieved, and fourth place in 400 meters, and four golds and one silver. So all this she has obtained. P.T. Usha's story is that of a gifted child from humble origins, achieving international success through sheer dedication and immense hard work. Never in the history of independent India has a youngster from a remote background town of rural origin caught the imagination of youth in particular and the public in general as Usha has, said the professor of English in Usha's hometown. So here gifted means something like it is given by God. So she is a gifted child from humble origins, means very low origins. That means she was born in a very small village, and she is a second daughter. So her origin was low, but she achieved international success. How did she achieve? Through sheer dedication. Dedication means devoted to a task or purpose. So she was devoted to do her task of reaching the heights in her sport, and immense hard work. Immense means extremely large or great hard work she did to achieve this. And a professor told about Usha's hometown that never in the history of independent India has a youngster from a remote background town of rural origin caught the imagination of youth in particular and the public in general as Usha has. So the success that she has achieved has grasped the attention of the youngsters, as she was from a rural origin. Her origin was not a big one, a good one, but even after that, because of her dedication and her hard work, she was able to reach great heights, and all the youth's imagination was caught by her they were motivated by her. Understood the lesson, children? With this, a reading is finished, and meanings and question answers I will be sending you tomorrow. Clear with the lesson? See you in the next class, children.